What up? So, how's everybody doing tonight?
Well, I'm doing well. I prefer if you call me Kirima.
All right, Kirima.
I also like the title Original Soul Goddess.
Oh, okay. Oh, how about Original Ebony Goddess? Oh,
really? Can you feel the tension in the air right now? I know I can.
Capoeira me mandou dizer que já chegou, chegou para lutar.
Welcome to the lounge. I had fun this morning on my way to work listening to Curious Shit. Sorry, Kurima and Vuk do a hangout titled Relationship Advice over at Kurima's channel. What I thought was ingenious about this broadcast was that they stole questions aimed at Dear Abby, but then they gave these answers that had socio-political context. You know, so why is my wife always tired? And Vuk or Kurima would say, because your wife does all the domesticated work, plus the upbringing of your children, and you just got one job. As our ancestors in the struggle back in the 60s used to say, the personal is the political. The first hangout on the channel is the relationship advice episode, but you have to scan forward after the first hour or so to get to that part, because the previous segment was from last night's Food for Thought, where we debunked the lie that feminists somehow had to do with Birth of a Nation's low ticket sales. So skip to that. I'll provide the timestamp in the low bar where you can start listening to Curious and Voot. Either way, I thought it was an excellent show during my commute.
One rant I need to get off my chest is us as black people is policing what we can talk about or argue about amongst each other in public. You see this all the time. First of all, I'm tired of this idea that we're the most and only dysfunctional group on the face of this planet. No, we might fight publicly a lot, whether it's along gender lines, class lines, or the issue of colorism. But first of all three of those things I just mentioned, guess what? Everyone else is dealing with that too. They're not better for it because we don't hear it from them. All you have to do is pay attention and you'll see it. The movie Price Above Rubies, although it's a movie, it's based on poems, books written by Jewish women and how they've always dealt with patriarchy in their communities, be they Orthodox or even Reform. Matter of fact, if you want to talk about colorism, that even exists within the Jewish diaspora. When the women of that community talk about straightening their hair, you would think that it was almost as much of a ritual as getting a bas mitzvah. If you want to talk about colorism amongst Asian people, here's a perfect example of that. On our weekly TV night, it's the only night we actually watch TV as a family, that was last night, Friday night. And we were catching up on all the TV shows that our 11-year-old can watch with us. And one of those TV shows was Fresh Off the Boat. In that situation, the older brother, rather the main character, the one who was sent by their father to go live in America and, you know, become the success that the main character is, came back to Taiwan. I think they're from Taiwan, to celebrate his younger brother's wedding. Now, he was already having an attitude that he was kind of like the white person of his own country, because after all, they were the white people of their own country, i.e. they were upper middle class, that kind of thing. And so when he came back, he thought that his brother, that they went to a movie set where his brother said, oh, you can come and meet my bride-to-be here on the movie set. And the older brother, the main character, immediately went to this sort of stocky-built dark-skinned boom operator who happened to be a woman, and he thought that that was going to be his wife. He was like, no, this is my wife. And we see that she's actually the actress who they're filming for. She was the high ideal of beauty, you know, for the Asian mainstream standard, I guess. She was of a light skin complexion. Obviously, she went under the knife to have work done on her eyes, which is something else that people think Asian people are hiding. But there's been plenty of documentaries about the Asian image and how they deal with beauty now these days. They don't want themselves looking too Asian. They go under the knife to get their eyes rounded out, or at least the men of that culture feel that they should be that way. So every group has their theme. And even in that scene, the point is you can see that the bride-to-be was supposed to represent this beauty, and represent this beauty standard, but it was completely in contrast with who the main character thought his younger brother was supposed to marry. But you can see that playing out. Let me also tell you that I've been to plenty of spoken word, slam poetry. If a Latina gets up there, we're going to hear a whole bunch of shit. The men who won't give their women of that community their last names, that kind of thing. So I just really hate when Black people try to police each other about what we can and cannot talk about in public, or when we throw this idea on each other that we are the most dysfunctional group in the world because we have these particular issues. And usually those people, the ones who really want to, you know, they're usually the ones that want to target all Black women for how fucked up the Black community is, or they're the women who want to target Black men for how fucked up the Black community are. Both of these kinds of Black people don't even have non-Black people in their lives. And you can tell that, because if they did, they really wouldn't be saying half the shit that they say. Believe me, other communities are fucked up. So that's all I got to say about that issue. Get over yourselves. Stop trying to police each other about what we can and cannot talk about in public. And no, we're not the only ones that are fucked up with internalized issues. Intrinsic. Synonyms: deep-seated, inherent, innate, underlying, constitutive, connate, congenital, indwelling, particular, fundamental, natural. These are all other words you can use besides the word intrinsic. You would think that since you've been on YouTube since 2006, and you now have well over 1,000 fucking videos repeating yourself for over 10 years, that you would know better to expand your vocabulary. Stop using the word intrinsic as if you just learned it yesterday and that it's like your favorite word. I thought I would help you out. Well, that's it for the lounge, everyone. I just wanted to get off those couple of rants. Drive home safely.